inclination of our hearts be acceptable in thy sight, O God, my rock and my redeemer. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The prophet Micah asks, with what shall I come before the Lord and bow myself before God on high? We have seen the answer to that question today, beloved in Christ, as Henry Isaac was brought to the waters of holy baptism. There was nothing in his hand that he would presume to offer to God his Father. He came, as we all must come to God, as a poor, miserable sinner, with nothing on our own, with no power or strength in ourselves. And he received from God justice and kindness and humility as Christ was placed upon him in the waters of holy baptism. And you also have put on Christ, as we sang, in you, in him you have been baptized. You have put on Christ, hallelujah, in the waters of holy baptism. You also come to God as a beggar, hands empty. You are unable to pay the great debt that you owe for your sin, and yet you come before God in his kindness, in his justice, in his humility, in Christ. You come before God, the righteous judge, who has begun a good work in you, trusting that he will bring that good work to completion, and you plead with him, and you beg to him to have mercy on you, to forgive you all of your sins, and just as the master forgave the servant who owed the great amount that was unable to be paid, so God has forgiven you the debt of your sin, which would drag you down to the depths. God has had mercy on Henry this morning. God has had mercy on each one of you. He comes to you in your sinfulness, scattering the seed of his holy word. He scatters indiscriminately upon thorny ground, upon rocky ground, upon the path, and upon fertile ground. And it is his word that produces abundantly. It is his word which changes hearts and souls. It is his word upon which we stand securely, trusting. And it is by his word that we may forgive our neighbors. Not one time, not seven times, not even 70 times seven times, but to infinity. It is only by God's word that we are able to forgive, for it is God's word that has shown us what true forgiveness is. You have seen it this day. And though it's easy to forget when an adorable little child is brought to the waters of holy baptism, this adorable little child is in fact a poor miserable sinner. This adorable little child was conceived in iniquity. This adorable little child is under the sway of sin and death and the devil until he is brought to the waters of holy baptism. It is easy to forget this. God has spoken very clearly. The Word of God calls a thing what it is. The Word of God in mercy calls you all sinners and then calls you to Christ, who is the justice of God, who is the kindness of God, who is the humility of God that you have put on yourselves. For it will not avail you to bring burnt offerings with calves a year old. It will not avail you should you bring thousands of rams with ten thousands of rivers of oil. It will not avail you should you even bring your firstborn for your transgression. For God has provided his firstborn, not just for your transgression, not just for your sin. God has provided his firstborn. Behold, the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world. That you, being washed in his blood, that you, eating his precious body, not die but live and recount the works of the Lord. That you who have been forgiven much are now able to show mercy and kindness and the justice of God in humility, trusting that God is the one who has begun this good work. It is God who will bring it to completion. And so we commend Henry to the loving hands of our Lord Jesus Christ, upon which his name has been imprinted by those horrific nails on the cross of Calvary. We commend Henry. We commend all of God's people who have been washed in these holy waters to this truth. God has begun it. God will complete it. We keep our eyes fixed on Christ Jesus. We live now not to ourselves, that is, not to death, not to sin, not to satisfy the desires of the flesh. We live now to Christ, who is our good shepherd, who is even now leading us through the valley of the shadow of death, to his green pastures, beside those still waters. He has prepared a table before us in the presence of our enemies, that we may live in him, trusting boldly, not on our own works, but upon the mercy of Christ Jesus. Trusting boldly that when we are sinned against, when we are persecuted, when we are hated, when we are reviled, it is not for us to take vengeance. It is for us to show mercy. It is for us to show kindness. It is for us to live humbly in the Lord. This, beloved, is our sacred call. It is our life in Christ. We live it because he has lived for us and died for us and rose again for our justification. We may sing with all the saints throughout all eternity, oh, the height of Jesus' love, higher than the heavens above, deeper than the depths of sea, lasting as eternity. Love that found me, wondrous thought, found me when I sought him not. This is the wondrous love God has given to Henry, God has given to each of you who have been baptized into Christ. This is the wondrous love that produces great and abundant good works for the sake of Jesus Christ in his kingdom. So, beloved, keeping your eyes firmly fixed on Jesus, the founder and perfecter of our faith, we boldly go out to the world confessing this faith, confessing Christ, living in his mercy. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.